Hello everyone, we'll solve the next problem. In this problem, what they are given is sin x into sin of cos x. We have to integrate by using the substitution method. So here we have to integrate sin x sin of cos x dx. Here we'll take t equal to cos x. When you differentiate t, we'll get dt. When you differentiate cos x, we'll get minus sin x dx. But here we don't have minus, so we'll take minus here. So we'll get minus dt equal to sin x dx. But we have sin x dx. So no issue here. Okay, understood? See here, we are assigning cos x equal to t. T we are differentiating, we are getting dt. Cos x we are differentiating, we'll get minus sin x and dx we'll get for x. Okay, but here, in this question, minus is not there, but here we are getting minus. So, we are moving minus from right hand side to the left hand side. That means, sin x dx is nothing but minus dt. We have sin x dx. We will substitute in this question. Integration of sin x dx is nothing but together is minus dt. We will put it inside the bracket. And then, what is cos x? Cos x is nothing but t. So, we will get sin of t. Okay, so sin we'll write as it is, cos x nothing but t, we'll write here t. Here in this conversion, we don't have any x variable. So this is fine. That means, whatever the new variable introducing, everything should be converted into new variable. It is got converted, okay. Now we'll integrate, we'll bring the minus in the front, minus integration of sin t dt. Integration of sin t is nothing but minus cos t. We'll get minus cos t, okay. Plus c. So that means integration of sin t is equal to minus cos t. Okay. So minus into minus plus. So we'll get cos t plus c. So here the cos in t, that is a new variable. So what is t actually? Cos x. So we'll get value cos of cos x plus c. This is the value for sin x sin of cos x. Understood? If you have any doubts, comment in the comment section. I will clarify your doubts. Understood?